Hi, I'm Josh Anderson, Director of Assistive Technology for the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Recently, our team was lucky enough to attend the ATIA conference in Orlando, Florida. Please enjoy this tech tip from one of the vendors from the exhibitor hall.
Hello, my name is Roland Mattern. I'm the Director of Sales for eSight. eSight is our wearable assistive technology for individuals with central vision loss due to AMD, Stargardt's disease, but it's really agnostic to disease and really works with the symptoms. We target individuals with visual acuity from 2080 up to 2600, and in many cases can get our users back to 20/20 for reading and for activities of daily living. We're here at ATIA in Orlando 2024, showcasing our latest product, the eSight Go, which is due to commercialize at the end of March, end of Q1 2024. The way the technology works is there's a camera on the front of the device which captures a central image the person can no longer perceive, and then runs it through some software which allows the wearer to manipulate the image with contrast, color filters, magnification, brightness, and those type of parameters to optimize it for viewing. It then projects that image onto two mini OLED monitors, one in front of each eye, and we can also integrate custom prescription lenses should the wearer still benefit from them for their vision. That image is then essentially blasted onto the entire retinal surface. Whatever photoreceptors still are functional and fire will get that visual stimulus to the brain for processing. And the way our users describe it is, as they dial in the settings, this blind spot literally shrinks away. So whether you want to use it for reading, watching TV, live theater, or going to the park, going to the store, this device will give you not only functional vision, but because we don't occlude the peripheral vision, you can be ambulatory with it as well. So as an example, as I wear it, we have the neck battery which goes comfortably around your neck, which gives you 4 to 5 hours of wear time. Now I wear the device. My peripheral vision is unobstructed, so I can walk navigating with my peripheral vision, but if I need it momentarily to see an Uber license plate, a price tag, or object in the store, I can use it like a bioptic and just glance up momentarily, or if I walk up to an individual, I don't recognize them, I can use the device to see them. Or if I'm reading, watching TV, or I'm at a live theater show or a live sporting event, I use the camera full time to see what I want to perceive.
Well, that's your tech tip for today. I want to say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.